Hello and welcome back. It's good to see you again. When last we left off, I was extolling the virtues of twitchy people. God, I love twitchy people. They're just so settling. They are the opposite of unsettling, and they put my mind at ease. Oh, thank you, twitchy guy. You have put my mind at ease. See? Just like that. Now let's stomp on these dead people. Maybe they have things I can take. Again with the frame rate loss.
The infection process is doing something strange to these soldiers.
Really?
They all have built-in stasis units in their body armor. The infection is merging the stasis unit into their flesh or something, making them move fast. Real fast.
I'm pretty sure that goes against the logic of what stasis units do. I mean, for that to make perfect sense, stasis units would have to slow down everything else in the universe, or just... Yeah, they only slow down one thing, so they're not speeding me up. So that makes no fucking sense. Logically, they should be slower. Yeah. Fuck you. Oh yeah. It's like a ballet. Of blood, guts, and... Oh, gross. Oh my god, these guys are grotesque. They're worse than the normal dudes. Oh, please die forever. And stay super dead. Like there's normal dead and then there's super dead. And I'd like you to be super dead. Super dead requires a true resurrection. Even a wish spell or a miracle. Hell no, not even a true resurrection you can get super dead reversed. Wish spell only. Major deities only. Ain't no demigods up in here. Ain't no demigods resurrecting some super dead dude. Ain't gonna happen. That's why I want you super dead. I don't know if there's a demigod lurking around here. I know Thor's around that corner. Waiting to resurrect you. By hitting you with his hammer. Yeah, because the electric...
Isaac, can you fall again?
No! It's the last thing I want to do. What's wrong with you? God, it's disgusting. Oh, wow, this ship is really... really brown. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with that. You understand, right? You understand? Two people who have subscribed to me. This is
Isaac,
two.
I'm tracking your position,
people.
But it doesn't look like I can.
Would you like to be the third?
This damn ship was nearly shared in half.
No, you're.
I made it to the bridge. It's a mess here. These poor bastards didn't stand a chance.
Oh, yeah?
I'm going to override all door locks so you can get to the engine room. I'll try and catch up with you there.
Here's the question. If all these super trained super soldiers with their super guns and their super armor are not standing a chance against these things, why am I just an engineer? Not even a super engineer, just a fucking engineer. Why am I surviving and mowing these things down left and right? What makes me special? Well, I suppose it could be the equipment. I mean, metalworking tools are primarily made for shearing, cutting, bending, breaking, tearing. You know, all the things that bullets are not made for. Bullets being made for puncturing, and, well, that's about it. So I guess if you're using normal bullets, these things seem invincible. Because how many fucking bullets is it going to take? Yeah, thanks. How many bullets does it take to separate? Yeah. You ain't gonna resurrect nobody around here. Nobody. They true dead. True death. God damn it, Suki. No. I was supposed to go that way, so I'm not gonna go that way. Woo! Hi. Damn it. Damn it again. Warning. Those with epilepsy are related
to... Mr. Clark, I need to speak with you. My name is Terence Kine.
Ah, do you believe, Terence? Do you believe?
Listen to me. There isn't much time.
Oh, yeah, there is.
If you really can repair the shuttle, there is a better use for it than just running away.
Yeah, going out of the liquor
store.
You
must understand, the forces at work here are greater than you can imagine.
I don't know, I got a pretty good imagination.
If you leave now, you condemn all humanity. The planet will never stop, never rest, unless the marker is returned. Don't you see? The church is wrong. This is all a trap. I've seen it. Please, you must help me.
Although that new pope is a pretty swell guy, but, you know, relative to his fellows. Pretty swell dude. Nifty guy. What do you got? Yeah, yeah. Dude, I'd help you, but... there's no script for it. It's not in the script. Oh, you. Two of... No. Just hit yourself. Go nap yourself. You dick. I don't like these guys. They seem like jerks. Like most of these necromorphs, they just seem like, grr, I'm gonna eat you. These guys are like, you dick. Fuck you. And I don't like that. Puts off the wrong vibe. Okay. Yes, hit points. I could always use more hit points. What? Not so quick draw.
This is Commander Cadigan. We have hostiles on board. Yeah. This is not a drill. Hostiles are alien. Repeat, alien and extremely dangerous. Mm-hmm. All personnel, have weapons ready and fire at will.
Not a bad policy. Oh God, really? Ugh. Oh, it gives me infinite ammo. Oh yeah, I'm cool with this. Yeah. Yep. Fucking dead space controls. Oh, this must be fun for you people. Alright, I'm done. Probably waste an hour on that if I was not recording this. But I have to think of my viewers, don't I? Yeah, you guys, you two guys. Or ladies, I don't know. It's the internet, I don't know. Oh. Why did you do that? You're supposed to keep that there. Like it's supposed to stay on your torso. Just saying, that's generally a good idea not to remove that from its starting position. That's an optimal position for that. Okay, why is a medical laser that powerful? Saw you faking dead. You think you sneaky, but you not so sneaky. I bet they taste good. I don't know that. I bet explosions taste like strawberries. No, strawberry parfait. Sounds good. Sorry, I'm hungry. Is that a crime? Is it a crime to be a fat dude? Okay, I'm not really that fat, but still. Always hungry. I could stand to lose a few pounds. And now that you have that mental image in your head of me as some horribly obese dude, I can just fly away into the sky to success. Yep. That is now how you think of me. Glad I did that. Ugh. As you know, you claim one thing about yourself, people are always going to think something else. Especially if you dwell on it as long as I have been. Oh, I'm self-aware. More debris! Or debris, if you're from a certain area. Uh-oh.
Lockdown initiated.
Oh, hi. Uh-oh. Flub that one. Love that one. Come on, fucking stasis being slow and unresponsive. Ah, stasis. Right, come on. Spider-Manning. Stop Spider-Manning. God damn it, Uncle Ben. I will stomp the baby. Kick the baby. Plasma ammo. Dicks. Oh, fucking hell. Well, that went well. Look at that. That is just precious. Precious memories. I'm gonna savor this forever. More of you? Yeah. Yeah, I get it. You're... get ADD or something. I don't know. Right.
Lockdown lifted.
Really? Is that what happened? Because it seemed to me like what just happened was a cleanup. The goddamn janitor. Eyes only, priority black, from Chief of Staff, Earth Defense Force. Attention, Commander Cadigan F. Operation White Light. Theater. Aegis System. Planet pending. Objective. Deep cleanse. CEC vessel USG Ishimura in breach of government order. They're believed to have recovered marker 3A. Special Ops has been confirmed the system, but has been unable to provide the planet location. Special Ops advises caution. If marker 3A has been recovered, infection by a lethal organism is a credible threat. Shock point to Aegis System. Move to position out of local scope range and wait signal from Ishimura to confirm location. So yeah, they had the dudes just sitting there waiting to hear rescue signal. So they come in and mop everything up. Prudent, but they should not have had people in arms and armor and shit. What they should have done was just had a couple ships with some big old guns firing big old bullets or whatever you use in space these days. And the second they got confirmation of disaster in the Ishimura, let loose hell. You don't make friends, but you don't have the opportunity to make enemies that way. Because they're all dead. People who would have been your enemies, they're dead. Wow, I had a lot of stasis packs. Doop a 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 doop.
Power node.
Cannot have enough power nodes. Alright, so I got 45 plasma poofs in backup. Well, apparently I'm horrible at math. I have 55 and 16 in the chamber, I guess, for this. I'm not sure what this weapon uses. Don't tell me there's another leg dude back there, because I cannot accept that there are two dudes doing leg stuff. Unless they're doing it to each other, because, you know. Those things didn't happen. But... okay. Can't shake the feeling I've been here before. Not here to kill you, dude. If anything, I'd be like, yeah, you want to pick up a gun and shoot things with me? Because we could totally do that. Nope, gotta wait for three for that. Where the fuck did you go? Ugh. Ugh. Indeed. You said it, Isaac. Ugh. Yeah. Okay. Okay. What horrible fate awaits me? Red glowy stuff, apparently. Which, as we all know, is bad. Unless you're playing TF2. Oh, yeah, so that's... because that's just a great place to have engines, is pointing into your own ship. What am I supposed to do there? Oh, okay. This is the least OSHA-compliant future workplace I've ever seen. The only workforce that could be less compliant with OSHA standards would be the Strog. I'm talking Quake 4 Strog here. Those guys are... they do not concern themselves with safety. What the?
Engine power failure.
Jesus. Better run, because something's about to happen.
You got it? Oh my god! You got it! That's the piece we need. Get to the crew deck.
Would love to. But I can't. No, seriously, I can't. Oh, there you are. Yay, things collapsing underneath me. Oh, okay. Cool. Reach into these flames and grab my valuables. You know what? I don't need to even kill things right now. I just need to blast them out of the way and keep on moving.
Trying to reach you with my convoy now. You got the singularity core, that's our ticket out of here. Get that convoy shuttle! Don't wait for me!
Oh, move.
Fuck me!
Peter Mensa, no! Oh, Peter Mensa, no! Come on, just... God, Peter Mensa, why did it take so long for you to die? I mean, the fact that you died at all was horrible. The fact that it took you so long is even worse. Highly overrated. Bitch.
I just lost all of Hammond's vitals. Is he dead? Oh god. It's just us now, Isaac.
Took you long enough to respond on that one.
Warning. Catastrophic failure of fuel containment. Evacuate the vessel immediately.
Doing that.
Catastrophic failure of fuel containment.
Yeah.
Evacuate the vessel immediately.
Already doing that. Senor nags a lot.
Warning. Catastrophic failure of fuel containment. Evacuate the vessel immediately.
Yeah, I get it.
Catastrophic failure of
you know what I also get?
Evacuate the vessel immediately.
Just why kids love the taste of Cinnamon Toast Crunch. I'm just kidding. I really doubt Kellogg's is going to sponsor.
Warning. Catastrophic failure of fuel containment. Evacuate the vessel immediately.
Food manufacturers that largely strike me as the kind of people who only hear about the internet through distant friends and relatives and really have no idea what it is. Just my impression. Oh, cool. Yeah, I'm just gonna jump away from that huge explosion. Hope you don't mind. Okay. So, went in, wrecked the place, left like a boss. Because that's what bosses do. That is what bosses do.
Exiting zero gravity.
I'm well aware, miss.
Exiting vacuum.
Thank you. Do 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 do. Oh, hello. Yeah. You're on the love boat with me. Exactly what I wanted. Yay. Okay. Oh yeah. 25,000 credits. I will part with my credits in exchange for your goods and or services. If you know what I mean. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you guys know what I mean. New item, huh? What I got? What I got? What I got? Nope. Yes. Maybe. I will indeed. I like buying things with money that doesn't exist. Things that exist with money that isn't real. I mean, things that don't exist with money that isn't You get it. I'm pretty sure you get it. You understand me, don't you? We're comrades, right? You and me, you two guys, or gals. Or in between, I don't know. It's the internet.
Chapter 9, Dead on Arrival, completed. Chapter 10, End of Days.
Yes.
Isaac, I've located the shuttle Hammond found. Shit. No good.
What is it this time?
That shuttle's brain dead. Someone removed the navigation cards. God knows why.
Because it's a video game.
There's three of them scattered around the deck. I'm downloading their locations. I can't access the doors from here, so you'll need a crew key.
Shit.
If you can find those parts, I think we can get that shuttle operational again.
I gotta get the red key card, and the blue key card, and the yellow key card. So I can open the door. Fight John Romero himself. Oh, hell no! Hell no! I ain't up for all this weird, creepy magic shit. Shaolin versus Space Ninja? Yes! Yes! Oh, fucking hell. Talk about Creepazoid. Also pretty Creepazoid. It's Creepazongas up in here. Are those masks? Does everyone have masks? I mean, if you live adjacent to a vacuum, I suppose an emergency oxygen supply would be pretty helpful. Isaac, why are you sounding pained? And you shut up, singing lady. And having none of your shit. She's still singing. Fucking hell. Biomass. This is a biohazard. This is unsafe working conditions. What now? Oh, nothing now. You're just gonna scare the shit out of me and leave. Thanks, dick. Appreciate that. Just gonna scare the shit out of me and leave. You're an ass. See, this is much creepier than any bloody flailing gore. Ooh, level 5 suit. Bloody flailing gore doom. Doomhammer gore death. Z-ball rules. Step on the lighted platform and activate it to start the game. Jump to as many scoring platforms as possible to increase your score multiplier. Then, use your Kinesis module to grab the ball and shoot it into the active basket before the shot timer runs out. Beating each level opens a locker with a reward inside. Alright, why not? I'll give it a shot. Let it never be said I do not show you things.
Entering zero gravity.
Do I start this way? Oh, I have to. Necromorphs know how to play Z-Ball. and tough. Okay, where's this fucking ball? Did I even start the game? I don't think I started the game. Oh, okay.
Starting game, level one.
This is remarkably boring. It doesn't actually strike me as a game as much as it does a challenge to beat these controls. Suit schematic, so I'm going to buy me that suit, and then I'm gonna find a save point. Hello, hello, hello. Nope, nope. Okay, okay. Whoa! That frame rate is killing me. Lady, still fucking singing. You keep on singing, lady. I don't give a shit anymore. I'm gonna rest, first. What do I... Where's the level 5 suit? 60,000! Okay. Right. Yeah, pretty sure. Do I do it? Do I do it? Do I do it? Fuck it, I'm doing it. Didn't use any nodes on that thing anyways. Armor is more important. Alright, let's see what this baby looks like.
Oh, I'm looking forward to this.
It looks really cool, actually. Almost the same, but more streamlined, more integrated with the armor.
I like it, I like it, I like it a lot.
Is there a level 7? I mean a level 6 suit? No, I have to imagine this is the last suit, because that's all of my inventory space. Yeah. Okay. Let's find me a save point. There's a save point. Let me read you this article.
United we ascend? Is Unitology a New Hope or just another scam? By Carrie Von Otkin. If you've been living on Mars for the past 200 years, you might have missed the fastest growing religious movement in history. Unitology boasts a following of millions, counts powerful CEOs and officials in its ranks, claims $78 billion of stock in multi-global companies, and owns two of Earth's largest financial institutions, GPSG Financial and Unitas Energy Investments. From its beginnings as a cult of personality, Unitology has become a respected, established religion. Most people know the basics. 200 years ago, Michael Altman, a professor of anthropology, blew the whistle on what he claimed was the biggest cover-up ever instituted by the Earth government. The discovery of an artifact, or marker, which proved beyond any doubt that there is alien life in the universe. The government labeled Altman a kook, but his claim struck a chord with some, and his mysterious death soon afterwards fueled that interest. Unitologists believe the marker contained a code, the key to eternal life, through rebirth and ascension to heaven. The kicker is you have to die first. They say the government is hiding the marker somewhere, keeping its secrets for themselves. Across all of human space, Unitologists praise Altman's martyrdom and await the day God comes to take them to their new life beyond death. It all sounds pretty harmless, but like any cult, there's a dark side. Unitologists are ranked in the church. No one ever talks about it, but most of its critics believe that there are at least 3 ranks above the average believer or initiate. With each new rank, more of the church's inner workings and research is revealed to a follower, and these ranks are achieved by one simple criterion: giving money and power to the church. Think taking all your money is bad? The church also requires members to donate their bodies after death. Why? What do they do with them? Nobody will say, and attempts to infiltrate the inner circle have failed. With their emphasis on transformation and rebirth, maybe we wouldn't like the answer even if they told us. One rumor, that also refuses to die, says the church is funding a secret shipbuilding program. Some claim to have seen the fleet. No documentary evidence has ever been supplied. But the claimants all say these mausoleum ships, despite their huge size, continued on page 94. Shit. Sorry, got a bit of post-nasal drip. Can't read very well. Out loud. Alright. That's it for this episode. If you liked it, do what you feel is best. Like, comment, or subscribe. Either way, I appreciate it. If you don't, that's okay. Thanks for your time anyways. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next episode. Goodbye.